Hello, myself Dr. Manjit Patil. I am consultant plastic and cosmetic surgeon working at Astra RV Hospital, JP Nagar. Today I'll be discussing about a topic called breast augmentation. So what exactly is the breast augmentation? It is the surgical procedure done to enhance the volume of and also the projection of the breast. So it is generally done in a patient who has fully developed breast, in the sense someone is 18 and above of age group, and who have a more realistic expectation, and those who are unhappy with their present size, and those who are seeking improvement in their size, volume as well as shape. It improves the volume as well as the projection of the breast. So in first consultation, we discuss with the patients what is bothering them about the size and what improvement they are expecting in it, and we take few photographs, draw certain diagrams, explain about the surgical procedures, anesthesia, risk and expected outcome in it. So we have saline filled implants as well as the silicone implants. So basically it is the filling material in the implant based on which we differentiate. Saline gives a more firmer feel, and the silicone implants give a more soft feeling. And next is the depending upon the shape, either the implants can be round or it can be anatomical, in the sense they'll have a teardrop shape, in the sense that will be like a natural breast, lesser upper pole filling and the lower pole will be more filling, so that will give a more natural appearance of the breast. And the other one is the round implants, which gives a more fuller appearance, gives a better cleavage for the breast. And the next one is based on the texture of the implant, whether it is smooth or textured one. So smooth one generally gives a very smooth feeling, and the textured one doesn't have that smooth feeling. But the advantage of the textured implant is they don't move, they don't change the position, there won't be any displacement of the implants. The risk of the anesthesia, there may be possibility of hematoma and infection, swelling, bruises, and there might be a scar also. Generally the scar will fade away. There are certain ways to tackle the scar. We can minimize the scarring. So overall it is safe procedure. First, patient has to have a pre-anesthetic checkup, have a checkup with the anesthesiologist. We have to run few lab tests, see whether the patient is fit for the surgery, and once again have a discussion about the procedure, outcome, risk, complication, everything. Then decide and go ahead with the surgery. In case of breast augmentation, first step is always anesthesia, then comes the incision in the sense in the cut. So the cut can be either along your inframammary fold or along the areola or along through the axillary area. So then comes the where we place the implant. Implant can be placed either subglandular, that is just beneath the gland, or beneath the muscle, or there can be a dual plane where the implant lies either beneath the muscle partly and partly beneath the gland, based on the patient's profile. And after thorough discussion with the patient, we decide where to place the implant. Then comes the closure. We may put a certain tubes to drain out any fluid if it is collected, and then certain dressings, and that's it. That is the procedure. So one more question commonly asked: will there be a scar? Yes, definitely there will be a scar, but it will be very minimal. Specifically, if it is incision is along the inframammary fold. It will be barely visible. The scar will be along the fold. So only the scar can be seen when the breast is lifted. Otherwise, it is invisible. So next thing is, how about the recovery? So recovery, you may have to take 3 or 4 days of off, and subsequently you can start your routine work. You can go back to your office and routine work, and the most of this swelling, pain, everything subsides in a matter of 15 days. So after 15 days, full work can be resumed. So there is always one more option, that is called lipofilling. Those who don't want implant, what is the option? So we have also something called lipofilling, wherein we fill the fat instead of the implants. So is it suitable for all the patients? No, it is suitable only in few patients where the desired increase in the volume is less. Someone who is seeking too much of increase in the volume, they are not the right candidate. Someone who want only minimal increase and who don't want the implants, in those cases we can go ahead with the lipofilling, wherein the fat from the patient itself is taken. Fat can be either taken from your thigh or belly, and that can be put into your breast to enhance the breast. So we at Astra RV Hospital JP Nagar, we have a full cosmetic surgery services. So for further details, please contact the Astra RV Hospital.